As we start a new hurricane season, many of you are still fighting your insurance companies over Ian claims.
The goal of one new law is to hold those insurance companies accountable and get them to more fairly pay out your claims. Wink News consumer reporter Andreana Shepherd tells us lawmakers say the Insurer Accountability Act will bring more balance.
It's a big win for homeowners. After Hurricane Ian, so many of you complained about how you felt the insurance companies shortchanged you. State lawmakers listened and took action. Hurricane Ian left many of you with insurance claim horror stories. Public adjuster John Fuentes hears them day in and day out.
They're reporting things like, you know, I've been grossly underpaid. I didn't meet my deductible. This is a very common one.
And after taking deeper dives into some of those cases, Fuentes told me he discovered insurance companies changed their own estimates in order to pay his clients less. In one case, the insurer's field adjuster said his client needed a new roof. Documents later showed a desk adjuster changed that to the roof only needed to be repaired. So the homeowner got only $11,000.
I mean, I can see that they're committing fraud. It's a serious thing. This homeowner's not made whole again.
Independent adjusters warned state lawmakers about this issue prior to the legislative session.
This fraud committed by some of the insurance companies is more widespread than any of us could have imagined.
And lawmakers responded by passing the Insurer Accountability Act. Governor DeSantis signed the bill into law, which makes it a crime for insurers to change adjusters' reports without detailing who made the changes and why. They'll also have to keep tabs on any edits made and preserve all versions of their reports. Finally, insurance companies will have to tell the state how they handle claims.
They've got to stop changing our estimates or leaving our names on them. And, you know, they're just, you know, taking stuff out for no reason.
Struggling insurance companies will no longer be able to write new policies. Their higher-ups won't be getting any bonuses either. Mark Friedlander with the Insurance Information Institute told me many of these provisions exist in many other states.
It is, number one, consumer-focused. Number two, it tightens regulations in many areas, particularly the claim adjuster situation. And three, it follows many of the best practices we see in insurance regulation in states across the country.
Some say this law, which goes into effect next month, doesn't go far enough. The part that would have required insurers to report how much money and fees go to their parent companies and subsidiaries did not make the cut. The American Policyholder Association told me in a statement that it's disappointed that part is gone, but is, quote, encouraged Florida leadership is taking steps to hold insurers accountable to policyholders. Back to you.